Hello everybody, I wish you a very warm welcome to you all. In our previous video, we have discussed about the general characteristics of phylum Platyhelminthes. In this, we have to discuss about phylum Cnidaria. Okay, these are the first metazoan having 11,000 species. These are the Cnidaria are first metazoa having 11,000 species approximately. In 1847, the term Cnidaria was given by Lyukat. 1847. This phylum was named by Lyukat as Cnidaria. Then in 1888, the term Cnidaria was given by Hartzek. 1888, Hartzek gave the term Cnidaria to it. Why these are Cnidaria? Why these are called as Cnidaria? The name Cnidaria derived from nidoblast or nidocyte cells. Okay. The nidocytes, Cnidaria derived from nidocytes or nidoblast cell. These are special type of cells which are derived from the totipotent cell of the phylum. We have already told the totipotent cell in Porifera are archaeocyte cell, and in case of Cnidaria, the totipotent cells are present in the mesenchyme cells. Present in the mesogloia cell. These totipotent cells are called as nematoblast cell. Okay. So these nidoblast cells are associated with anchorage, defense, food capture. The nidocytes or nidoblast help in anchorage of individual, of food capturing, and also this it help in anchorage, food capture and defense. The basic function of nidoblast are that. Okay, so we will discuss about the general characteristic of Cnidaria. Come to it. First we will discuss about habitat of the individual. Okay. The individual of this phylum are aquatic. These are mostly aquatic in nature. And majority of the individual of this phylum remain in marine water. A few are fresh water. Mostly marine, and a very few individuals are found in fresh water. Okay. These are either sessile or free swimming in nature. These are sessile or free swimming in their habitat. This may be solitary, living in single, or sometimes they make colonial. The colonial concept can be studied from Physalia, which is Portuguese man of war. It shows colonial format. Okay. Symmetry, then come to after habitat symmetry. The body shows radial symmetry. Okay. In case of in another except hydrozoa, if we take the example of anthozoa, they take y-radial symmetry. Y-radial symmetry. In two planes, the body can be divided into equal part. But here, at any plane, any radial plane can divide the body into equal part. So it is radial symmetrical. But in case of anthozoa, except hydrozoa and scyphozoa, in anthozoa, biradial symmetry is seen. Okay, this is the symmetry. Then level of organization, it is also developed type. We have studied in porifera, there is no tissue, cellular grade organization. Here tissue organization is seen. Symmetry, next to symmetry, organization, level of organization, it is shows the organization, shows tissue level organization in it. Okay, the first tissue found in this phylum. Okay, and it do not have connective tissue, do not have connective tissue, remember it. It consists of epithelial tissue, nervous tissue, but connective tissue is absent in it. And the neurons are developed for the first time in this phylum. First time neuron developed first in this. Okay, this is the tissue level organization. There is a special type of cell, stinging cell or nematocyst cell, nematocyte cell. The nematocyte cell produces a toxin called as hypnotoxin. The hypnotoxin, what the role? To neutralize the prey, neutralize its prey. One of the important component which is released from the nematocyte cell. Okay, then come to germ layers. If we analyze the germ layers, these are diploblastic in nature. It consists of ectoderm and endoderm. Consist of, suppose this part is, there is a mesogloia between, this part is ectoderm, suppose this part is endoderm or gastrodermis. What are the different components are found in it? The ectoderm consists of nematocyte cell, ectodermal epithelial cells. It consists of interstitial cells and neuron. Ectoderm consists of nematocyte cell from which the neutralizing toxin is released. Except nematocyte, it produces ectodermal epithelial cell, ectodermal epithelial cells. It consists of neurons in it, nerve cell, neuron. Okay, nerve net is found in this phylum. In endoderm, endodermal epithelial cells and special type of endodermal epithelial cells and gland cells are present in endoderm. Okay, in between ectoderm and endoderm, there is mesogloia cells. Okay, the mesenchyme has been modified into mesogloia, which support both ectoderm and endoderm separating layer. The next to body plan, the body plan shows blind sac type of body plan found in it. Okay, the mouth is present in alimentary canal and nose is absent. Then if we take the body form, two distinct forms are found. One is polyp, another is medusa. The polyp is cylindrical part, while medusa is umbrella shaped. Okay. It shows metagenesis. That means the polyp is converted into medusa, and medusa can form polyp. Due to interconversion of polyp and medusa, it is called as metagenesis or alternation of generation. But this type of alternation of generation is not true type, because in every alternation of generation, there must be a haploid phase and another diploid phase. But in this case, the polyp is diploid, the medusa is also diploid. So we cannot take it as one of the true type of metagenesis. Okay, another type. We take the skeleton example of skeleton. Calcareous exoskeleton can be deposited, because if we take the example of coral, the coral is also belongs to this phylum. They started secreting calcium carbonate around their body, so they can produce calcium carbonate exoskeleton around the body. Large coral islands are formed by this skeletal secretion. Okay. Then digestive system. Extracellular type of digestion takes place in it. Okay. For the first time, the extracellular digestion seen in it. Then respiration, circulation, these have not. Then another important character, polymorphism. The polymorphism deals with the division of labor. Here, the polyp is divided into a number of joints. Medusa also divided into joints. Due to different type of joints in polyp and medusa, there is a distribution of work between different parts, which is called as polymorphism or division of labor. Okay. So it is about polymorphism. Then finally, we have to discuss about the reproduction. It is seen that most of the cylindrates or cnidaria are bisexual. These are bisexual in nature. Polyp reproduces by asexual method, medusa reproduces by sexual method. Okay. So these are the different characters associated with cnidaria phylum. In the next video, we'll discuss about another phylum. Then thank you all.